Good afternoon to all of you. I represent an institute called International Plant Nutrition Institute, which is a global organization with initiatives for addressing the world's growing need for food, fuel, fiber, and feed. So ours is a not-for-profit organization. We are 8 years old, and our primary mission is to develop and promote scientific information about the responsible use of plant nutrients for the benefit of the farm families. So we are supported by the global fertilizer industries, and we provide a scientific voice for the fertilizer industry, but we are scientifically credible and we are independent in terms of our activities. So if you see, we are a very small group. We are 34 scientists working across 13 program areas in the world. So I represent the South Asia program, and in South Asia, like, we have three supporting staff. And our primary focus when it comes to India, you know, unbalanced nutrient use is a quite widespread phenomenon in the country. So we are in the process of promoting the balanced use of fertilization through promoting the concept of 4R nutrient stewardship. That is, applying the right sources of fertilizers at right rate, at the right time, and in the right place. And you know, the other issue or the challenge that we have in the country is to, we do not have whatever the approaches that we have for providing fertilizer recommendations are outdated. They were developed long back. And now, so we have a concept of site-specific nutrient management, wherein we are capable of coming up with a fertilizer recommendation to an individual farmer. So the approach is, like, we have a dual mandate. We do research and education. So we work in partnerships. So partnership is one of our, developing partnerships is one of our major activity. So we work with the different scientists of the universities, the ICR system, the National Agriculture Research and Extension System, other stakeholders, be it the industry partners or the international organizations. So these are our stakeholders, and government extension is one of them. So we do research in collaboration with these partners, and the second main mandate is education. So whatever the findings that we have, we wanted to take them to the farmers through better education means. So as I told, like, we are a very small group, but if you look at the farmer, the number of farmers that we have, so it's really a challenge. That's why we have considered the use of website and internet as the means of taking our technologies or our developed information to the farmers. So this is our website, wherein we bring in all the developed information, be it in the form of research or be it in the form of publications, and then everybody can access this website. And you know, many scientists or the students, they visit this website and they come back to us and they come up with a proposal of developing a research program in their master's and PhD programs, and they take it forward. We do have our presence in the Twitter, Facebook, and we do have our own YouTube channel. And you know, we use this website and the internet as a way of means of communication. So we have a monthly interactions wherein we communicate with our stakeholders and partners, and we have a quarterly newsletter that we upload in the internet, and we also circulate to all our members in our mailing list on a timely basis. And you know, the another effective way of communication in our group is through webinars. What we do is, initially we identify an issue, and then we circulate to all the people in our mailing list, and we advertise in a big extent, and then we connect them. We invite the people to the website through GoToWebinar, and then we participate, we organize the training. And the other thing is, we develop videos. You know, we identify an issue and we provide a response in the form of a video, the very short video, so that people can go through it, and it would help as a solution for the identified issues. And we do take the advantage of ICT as a means of providing crop nutrient prescriptions. So we do develop decision support tools, which helps in providing prescriptions to individual farmers. So what we do is, once they are developed, so the development and validation itself takes years, like 3 to 6 years for development and another 3 years for validation. So once it is done, we upload it in our website, and then we provide all the toolbox. We call it as a toolbox. Like, we have a training module there, we have a user video, multilingual manuals. So everything is available. So a layman just visit the website, go through these tools, and then they can run the software by themselves and come up with a recommendation. So our initiatives were recognized. We were judged as the best ICT scalable ICT in the Bihar Innovation Forum, and we were appreciated by other agencies. These are some of the recognitions that we have. Even the Ministry of Agriculture, Government of India, has recognized one of our intervention, and then they recommended it in the centrally sponsored scheme called Soil Health Card. So I think you are aware of it. So these are some of our activities. We do trainings. We involve these internet and website-based tools for providing these activities. And you know, this is the way we empower the farmers. A farmer is capable of having a recommendation in his hand. We make impact in terms of improving their livelihood and through improving the productivity, profitability, and also creating a lesser impact on the environment. So this is the way forward. So thank you very much.